Some infants are born physically dependent on opioid drugs that they were exposed to during pregnancy. Some of these infants develop severe withdrawal symptoms shortly after birth, a condition known as neonatal opioid withdrawal syndrome, or NOWS. The babies cry and have problems sleeping or feeding. They also may experience numerous other symptoms. Infants with NOWS require hospital care after birth, often with opioid medications. As part of its efforts to find scientific solutions to the opioid crisis, the NIH HEAL Initiative investigates ways to improve care of infants with NOWS. This research shows that a care approach called Eat, Sleep, Console can help these infants get better more quickly, effectively, and safely with less need for opioid medications.
Our research is infants who have exposure to opioids during pregnancy often have a lengthy stay in the hospital, and that can be really disruptive to families and to communities. Prior to HEAL, we had each of the individual neonatologists doing what they thought was best practice. Really no standard approach to care.
I'm a neonatologist, a clinical researcher, and we have really been doing the same thing for babies with prenatal opioid exposure and potential withdrawal for the last 40 years.
There's very little evidence to support the care that we provide across the spectrum. So truly, the HEAL Initiative has allowed us to begin to systematically answer those questions and be able to optimize the care that we provide.
One of the primary questions that we're answering with this HEAL project is the best way to assess and manage infants who have neonatal opioid withdrawal syndrome. It's really important that we find the right assessment tool. This will help us to better understand which babies truly need to have medication therapy and which babies that we could treat without medication therapy and have the moms utilized as therapy to be able to do care with their babies, such as skin-to-skin care, being there with them, to be able to calm them without them having to go on to medications.
The studies that have been done on this previously have really been they're older and they have not included an appropriate control group. So we've not been able to tease out the effects of opioid exposure itself versus other things that might go along with it, like maternal mental health problems, other maternal medications or substance exposures and things like that.
Our primary outcome is looking at time until infants were medically ready for discharge. We found that with the use of the eating, sleeping, and consoling care approach, we were able to decrease that time by 7 days, an entire week of less time in the hospital. We also found that we were able to decrease the use of pharmacologic therapy by almost a third.
And what makes our study really important in my mind is the ability to really empower families and mothers in the care of their babies and to have them an integral part of the care team. It allows mothers to feel valued in their role as a mother and has been really important potential outcome for this work.